Good morning, everybody. Once again, I would like to request you all for welcome to this class of microcontroller. In the previous classes, we have discussed about the programming part of 8051. So, we have discussed about writing a program to count number of ones or number of zeros, or counting both number of ones and zeros in a given data byte. We have also discussed for a program to find sum of the given numbers and also to find the average of the numbers. And then we have discussed about a program to find largest of a given number or a smallest of a given numbers. Whereas I have given the last problem program for a transferring of data with overlap as an assignment. Okay, so we have discussed these programs. Okay, sum and average. And then largest of a number, right? So the basic logic used in finding the either largest number or a smallest number is what? Right? Take any two numbers, compare those two numbers, and then find out which number is largest or which number is smallest. And then if you have more than two numbers, then apply the same logic so as to find either a largest number or a smallest number, right? So in a program, what we have done is, you can look here, right? Compare, jump on, not equal, right? So what this instruction is doing is, it is comparing the two datas which are there in accumulator and then location 30H, and it is jumping if both are not equal, right? If they are equal means what? There is no question of finding either a largest number or the smallest number, right? So when they are not equal, right, there are two possibilities. That is, either data in A is bigger than the data in 30H or vice versa. So for finding that whether A is larger or the data which is there in location 30H is larger, we are using again one more instruction, that is jump on carry. So jump on carry, basically it will subtract A from 30, right? And when the carry will generate, when A is smaller than the data which is there in 30, right? Then that means when we are trying to subtract a smaller number from the bigger number, then a carry will be generated. So this is the logic what we have used in finding the largest number. Okay, so this same concept can be extended for arranging the numbers either in ascending order or descending order, right? So let us have a look at the program for arranging the numbers in ascending order. Right, you might be asked to write the program for arranging the numbers in descending order also, right? From smaller number to higher number in ascending order, whereas from highest number to the smallest number in descending order, right? So the logic used here is, right, you can look at this figure, right? The size is 5, that means we have 5 data. So the input will be what? The 5 numbers. Right, the numbers are 35, 10 to 21 and then F0. Okay, so these are the numbers and our task is to arrange these numbers in ascending order. Right, so ascending order means what? From smallest number to the largest number. So in a given list, the smallest number is 2, then next number is 10, third number is 21, next number is 35 and then last highest number is F0. So this is the input where the numbers are mentioned in a random order, right? and the expected output is what all the given numbers should be arranged in the ascending order from 0 to 10, 21, 35, F0. Whereas in case of descending order, right, with the same input and with the same size, the output will be getting is what? F0. First number will be F0, right, at location 1, then 35, then 21, then 10, and then 02. That is the expected output in case of descending order. So logic used will be what that we have discussed in the previous example of what finding the largest and the smallest number. So in case of finding the largest number, what we have done is let us take the first two numbers, 35 and then 10, right? So 35 is there in A with respect to the previous program of finding the largest number. So in A we have the 30, and then the next number, that is 10, is there in location 30, right? So basically what we are doing here is we are comparing 35 and then 10, right? So 35 and then we are comparing, and we are looking for whether they are equal or not equal. So in this case they are not equal. So according to this instruction, if they are not equal, it will jump to next this location DN, where we have instruction jump on carry. So this jump on carry, what it will do is it will subtract 35 minus 10. So 35 minus 10, what it will do is look at the instruction jump on carry. Okay, so jump on carry, 30 minus 10, so there will not be any carry generated. So in that case, what we are doing is we are moving A into 30H, right? Because presently, if you are comparing 35 and 10, 35 is the largest number, right? So you keep that number as it is, right? Discard this 10. Okay, so next what you do is you compare 35, which is the next number in a list, which is 2 here, right? So again 35 minus 2, again there will not be any carry generated because 2 is the smallest while 35 is the highest number. So 35 minus 2, again it is the largest number, so again discard 2. Then compare 35 with the next number in a list, which is 21. So again 35 minus 21, again 35 is the largest number, discard 21. Go to next location, the data in that location is F0. Now compare 35 with F0, right? So there is a difference here, right? Whenever we are comparing 35 with 10 or 2 or 21, all these three numbers are smaller than 35H, so there is no carry generated. Whereas whenever you compare a 35 with F0, where F0 is larger than 35H, so obviously whenever you are comparing, whenever you are trying to subtract a smaller number from the bigger number, that means 35 being the smallest number and F0 being the largest number, so 35 minus F0, obviously there will be a carry generated. So whenever a carry is generated, what we'll do is we'll swap these two numbers, right? So F0 will come to 35H and 35 will go to this location, right? So what we have done is there are 5 numbers in a list in a memory, and we have compared the first number with second number, and then third number, and then fourth, and then the fifth. And depending upon the number, whether it is smaller than the first number or the biggest from the first number, right? So once we complete this iteration, we'll be having F0 as an answer, which is the largest number. Okay. So the same logic can be extended for arranging the numbers in ascending order, right? So what happens is in a first iteration, what we'll get is when you compare 35 with 10, and then 10, 35 with 2, 35 with 21, 35 with F0, depending on whether carry generated or no carry generated, the numbers are rearranged. Right. So when you want to arrange the numbers in ascending order, right, we have to make a small change here, right? So 35 minus 10, there is no carry generated, right? So in an ascending order, we want the smallest number at the first place. So what we do is when you compare 35 with 10, there is no carry generated. So under this condition, what you do is you swap these two numbers, right? 35 and then 10. So 10 will come to this location, 35 will go to the next location. So the arranging of the numbers after first comparison will be 10, 35, 2, 21 and F0, right? And then you compare 10 with 2, right? 10 with 2, again, there is no carry generated. So you swap these two numbers, right? 2 will come to first location, 10 will go to third location. Again, you compare 2 with 21, right? Carry generated, so you keep the numbers as it is. Then you compare 2 with F0, again carry generated, so keep the number as it is. So after this first iteration, we will be getting 02 at the first location, F0 at the second, 02 at the first location, then 10 at the second location, 35 at the third location, 21 and F0 will remain as it is. So after first iteration, we will get the smallest number at the first location, right? But the remaining four places, the numbers are needs to be rearranged. So next iteration, we need to compare the data in the second number in a list with the remaining three, right? So after that iteration, we will get the second largest number in the second place. So that means we'll get 2 in the first location, then 10 in the second location, right? The remaining three numbers, we need to rearrange them, right? Again, after that iteration, we will get 2 in first location, 10 in the first location in the earlier cases. After this iteration, we'll get 21 in the third place in a list. Then after last iteration, right, all the numbers will be arranged in a ascending order. With a slight modification to the same program, we can change this program from ascending order to the descending order, right? So have a look at the flow chart. So initialize the number of elements in a counter, right? So if you are looking at this example, the total numbers in a list or size or counter is 5. That means there are total 5 numbers are there, which needs to be arranged in either ascending order or descending order. In this case, ascending order. Okay. So count will be 5. Initialize the pointer and number of comparison counter, right? So you need to keep in mind that we require two counters here, right? One is main counter, the other one is the sub counter, right? So there are two counters are required, so we need to initialize those countersign pointers, then get the numbers, right? Take the first two numbers for the comparison. So if the number is less than the next number, if the first number is less than the next number, right? So increment the pointer because the first number is the smallest number. If not, then interchange the contents, right? So increment the pointer, decrement the comparison counter, check whether the count is 0. If S, proceed. If no, then go to the third number, right? So then decrement the number of elements counter, as we said that there are two counters which are to be used, right? So again, you check for whether the second count is also 0. If yes, then stop. If no, again go to the this place, right? So once both the counters become 0, right, the first counter as well as the second counter. Then at the end of the program, we will be having the numbers which are assigned, which are arranged in an ascending order. Okay, so I hope you have understood the concept of arranging the numbers in ascending order with this example and this flowchart. Okay, so next is what? Let us go to the program. Okay, so ORG 000H, then short jump start, right? So start is what? Move R1 comma as of 05, right? This is a counter. This 5 indicates there are total 5 numbers which are to be arranged in ascending order. Okay, so move R1 into A, right? Then A to R2, then move R0 comma hash of 30H, then move A comma at the rate of R0, right? So increment R0, move B comma R0. That means in an R0, R0 is assigned which an address of 30H where we have 5 numbers, right? So what we are doing here is in register A and in register B, we are taking the 2 numbers, right, which are to be compared, right? So then clear the carry flag, then SUBB A minus B. So what this instruction will do is it will subtract A B from A, then jump on carry to skip. So when carry is generated, when A is smaller than B, then carry is generated. Otherwise, if A is bigger than B, so there is no carry generated. So if carry is generated, means what? A is the smallest number and we want that because we want to arrange the numbers in ascending order. So jump on carry to skip. Skip is what? Right, keep both those two numbers as it is because the first number is smaller than the second number. Right, decrement jump on non-zero, R2 to up. R2 is a counter, second counter. Okay, so its value is 5. Now it is decremented, it becomes 4. So it is not 0, it goes to up. Increment R0, go to the next location, that is take the third element in a list, right? And then continue this process, right? So this loop will be there until your first count becomes 0. Okay, if there is no carry generated, right, if this condition is not satisfied, then that means that A is bigger than B. So what you do is you swap the numbers, right? Because A is there in 30 and the data which is there in B is 31. So you swap those two numbers. That means that B is smaller than A. Okay. So you, once this count is 0, right, we have one more count, right? DJNZ R1. Right, R1 is also 5. So that means we said that there are two counters which needs to be used in the program for arranging the numbers in an ascending order. Okay, so once both the counter becomes 0, that means R1 and then R2, if both becomes 0, that is the end of the program, and you'll find that in a memory location, same memory location, that is 30, we have the numbers arranged in the ascending order. The same program you can modify for descending order by making a change of only, instead of jump on carry, you use jump on no carry. So the same program with only the modification of, instead of jump on carry, jump on no carry, right? If you replace JC with JNC, the same program will work for arranging the numbers in a descending order, right? So this is how we need to write the program for arranging the numbers either in ascending order or descending order, right? So please keep in mind before writing the program for any problem, first we need to understand what is being asked, right? So we must know what is meant by ascending order, what is meant by descending order, first important thing. Second important thing we require is the logic, how to arrange the numbers either in ascending order or descending order, right? There are various logic or techniques are there in arranging the numbers in either ascending or descending order. There is a bubble sort technique, there is an insertion sort techniques, right? So you must know these techniques and then you try to write the program. Next is write a program to find factorial of a given number. Okay. So again, as I said earlier, we should know what is factorial of a number and how to calculate it. Right. So as we all know that factorial of a given number is what? You take a number, decrement it, multiply them, further decrement it, multiply, further decrement it, multiply until your number becomes zero, right? Whenever your number becomes zero, you should stop there, right? So that is what is meant by factorial of a given number. For example, if someone asks you to find the factorial of a number five, so it is a factorial of a number is what? 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, right? So that is how we will find out the factorial of a given number. So if you are looking at the flow chart, right? So start factorial num 0, read the number, right? Read the number. First condition is what? Check whether the number is greater than 1, right? If the given number is 1, then factorial of that is 1 itself, right? So we need to stop there. If number is greater than if that condition is not satisfied, then print fact that itself is a factorial of a number and then stop. If number is more than 1, so fact is equal to fact into num, right? And then you decrement num is equal to num minus 1. For example, if you're talking about number 5, right? So is number is greater than 1? Yes, 5 is greater than 1. So it comes here. So fact is equal to fact into num. So num will be what? It is 5 minus 4, right? So here factorial will be 5 into 4 is 20. Then you decrement num is equal to num minus 1. So from 5 it will come to 4. So it goes to the loop. Again, number is greater than 1, right? So 5 into 4, it is 20. 20 into 3 is 60. Again, it goes here. 60 into 2 is 120. Again, decrement it. So it num becomes 1. So 120 into 1 is 120. Further decrement it, then it becomes 0, right? So at that point, you need to come out of the loop. So factorial of 5 is 120. Again, please keep in mind, we'll get 120 in the form of hexadecimal. So if you're looking at the number, right, for program for finding a factorial of a number, so move R1 comma hash of 04. That means here we are trying to find out the factorial of number 4. You can be able to find out which type of instruction it is, right? I suggest to all of you, whenever you look at the instruction, right, you should be able to find out which type of addressing mode is used and which type of instructions they are, right? So it is move R1 comma hash of 4 is data transfer instruction, and then it is immediate addressing mode. Right, and then move R7 comma hash of 01, again it is data transfer instruction with immediate addressing mode. So after the execution of these two instructions, R1 will be having the value of 04 and R7 will be having the value of 01. Okay, and then next instruction is move A comma R7, right? So R7 is again 1. So after execution of this instruction, accumulator becomes 1. Then you check whether the given number is 0 or what. So compare jump 1 not equal R1 with 0, 0, whether the given number is 0. So in this case, R1 is 4. So they are not equal. Okay. So next is what? You transfer move R1 into B. So the register B will be having the value of 4, right? Then mul A into B. A has got the value of 1. So it is what? 1 into 4. So here, after execution of this instruction, accumulator will be having the value of 4. So DJ NZ R1 up. So R1 earlier it was 4. After decrementing, it becomes 3, right? So what it will do, okay, so 4, now a accumulator has got 4 and R1 is decremented, so it becomes 3. So we need to multiply it. 4 into 3 is 12. Further decrement it. So R1 earlier it was 3, now it becomes 2. So it is 4 3s earlier it was 12. 12 into 2 is 24. Right. And then further decrement it, it becomes 1. So 24 into 1 is 24. Further decrement it, then R1 becomes 0. At that point, we need to stop it. So once this program is executed, right, accumulator will be having the value of a factorial of a given number. Okay, so again my suggestion to you all is try to execute this program and check whether you will be getting the correct answer or not, right? And okay, so this is how we need to write a program for finding the factorial of a given number. Okay. Next, move on to write a program to find Fibonacci series. Okay. So again, as I said, we must know what is meant by Fibonacci series. If you don't know what is Fibonacci series, right, it will not become easier for writing the program for it, right? As we all know that Fibonacci series is, for example, the initially you take the say two numbers, right? So 5 and 8 are the two initial numbers, right? So the fields are x5, x6, x7, x8, x9, x10. So 5 and 6 field have got a value of 5 and 8. So this x7 will be x5 plus x6. So 5 plus 8 is 13, right? So next number x8 will be x6 and x7. So 8 plus 13 is 21. So next number will be addition of the previous two fields, that is 21 and then 13 is 34. And the next field is what? Addition of previous two fields, that is 21 and 35, which is 55. The next number will be, it is addition of x10 and x9. 34 plus 55 is 89, and then so on. So basically, the Fibonacci series is for getting the Fibonacci series, we must have the two initial numbers, and from there on, you can go on generating the Fibonacci series. Right. So, for example, if the first two numbers are 0 and 1, right? So the next number will be 0 plus 1 is 1. Next will be 1 plus 1 is 2, and then so on. This is how we need to generate the Fibonacci series. Okay, now have a look at the program. Okay, so move R1 comma hash of 0A, right? This is a data transfer instruction with immediate mode addressing. So once this instruction is executing, R1 will be having the value of 0A, right? So intentionally I have left the comment field empty, right? So I again suggest to students to write the comment in front of every instruction, right? What that instruction is doing, apart from two important things, right? The type of instruction and then the type of addressing mode used, so that we can appreciate the programming part, right? So after execution of this instruction, R1 will be having value of 0A, then move R2 comma hash of 00 again, right? Everybody knows that it is immediate addressing mode and data transfer instruction. So after execution of this instruction, R2 will be having the value of 00. Then move A comma hash of 00 again, data transfer, immediate addressing mode, A will be having the value of 0. Then move DPTR comma hash of 2000H. After execution of this instruction, DPTR points to a location as mentioned, that is in this case 2000. Move X at the point of DPTR comma A, right? So A has got a value of 0. That data is transferred to DPTR, where DPTR is 2000. So 2000 location will be having a value of 0. Then increment A, earlier value of A is 0. Once you increment it becomes 1. Increment DPTR. So from 2000, it goes to the 2001 location. Then move X at the rate DPTR comma A. So A is 1, DPTR is 2000. So once this instruction is executed, 2001 will be having the value of 1. That means the initial two values, that is 2000 memory location has got a data of 0. 2001 memory location has got a data of 1. These are the two initial values using which we need to generate the Fibonacci series. Or in some cases, in some program, you may be given the numbers itself. Right? Instead of 01, somebody may ask you to write a program with initial value of, say, in this case, 5 and data or any other value. Okay. So decrement R1, decrement R1. Right. So twice we are decrementing R1. Initial value of R1 is 0A, that is 10. You are decrementing twice means what? From 10, it comes to 9 and then to 8. So by this time, you might have understood what is this 10, which is there in R1, is a count. That means we want to generate a Fibonacci series for a size of 10. Out of 10, the initial two values are 0 and then 1. So remaining 8 numbers we need to generate. So increment DPTR, the value of DPTR now is 2001. So you increment it, it becomes 2002, right? So move A comma hash of 00, move B comma hash of 01. These are the two values which are there in 2000 and 2001, right? Then add A comma B, so 0 plus 1, right? So that A you transfer to R2, right? And then again same, you move to 2002, right? So the first value is 0 here, right? 0 here. Second value is 1. Third value is 0 plus 1 is 1. Increment DPTR, right? Move B into B, R2 to B, DJ inject R1 loop, right? So it goes to this, right? So once this count becomes 0, at the end of the program, you will find that there is a Fibonacci series starting with 0 and 1, 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, and then so on, right? So for proper understanding of this programming, right, the simple way what we can do, right, for debugging, always what we can do is go on writing the content of every instruction, right? For example, what we'll do here is and try to write the content of the instructions which are being used in the program, right? So first is what? R1, right? So R1 is what? 10. So R1 is 10. Next, R2 is 0. Okay, and then A is 0. A is equal to 0. Then DPTR is 2000. So DPTR is 2000. This is the memory location. Okay. And then what we are doing is the content of A is copied to DPTR. So initial address of DPTR is 2000. So now 2000 will be having the value of 0. Okay. Then increment A. So if you are looking at the value of A is 00. So increment A means it becomes 01. Right. Again, what we are doing is we are incrementing DPTR. So DPTR earlier it was 2000. Now it becomes DPTR becomes 2001. Okay. And then you can check that A is copied into DPTR. So DPTR is 2001 and A is copied into that. So A value is 01. Right. So 2000 has got a value of 0. 2001 has got a value of 1. Okay. Then decrement R1, decrement R1. So R1 is 10. Once you decrement it, it becomes, now R1 becomes 09. And you are decrementing once again, it becomes 08. Right. So then increment DPTR. Now DPTR is 2001. Now it becomes DPTR is equal to 2002. Okay. Now you can look at that. We are moving A is equal to 00 and B is equal to 01. Right. Then add A comma B. So after this instruction, A is equal to A plus B. That means it is 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. Right. So now what we are doing is right, after adding, we are copying A into R2. So R2 becomes 01. And again, we are moving same into DPTR. So DPTR is 2002. DPTR is 2002, and that will be having the value of 01. So now look at this DPTR. I'll try to make it in red. DPTR has got first value of 0. Then in 2001, we have a second value, that is 1. Then third will be having 1. So the first three numbers of a Fibonacci series is 0, 1, and then 1. Right. Next, right, we'll be continuing this. So what will happen is, so 1, next number will be what, the addition of this number and the previous number. Right. So this number is 1, previous number is 1. So 1 plus 1 is, next number becomes 02, right? And then next number is what? This number and the previous number. 2 plus 1 is 3. And then so on. So this is how we need to generate the Fibonacci series, right? And go on executing this program. Either you can use this tabular format, or you can actually look at the execution part of this program in an 8051 environment, so that you can easily understand the what concept is being used in the program. Not only this program, any program, right? Now the same program can be written in another way also, right? So if you are looking at these two instruction, move a comma 00 and move b comma as of 01, right? What we are doing here is we are taking these two numbers, right? If you are taking these two numbers, then all these initial stages are not at all required, right? Now this 0 and 1 we have already in 2000 and 2001, so making use of that also we can write the program, right? So once you look at any program, try to execute the program as it is, right? Try to understand which logic is used and which instructions are used. And once you execute this program, once you get the result, try to shorten this program by removing unnecessary instructions, right? Why your question may be, why unnecessary instructions are added here, right? Until or unless we try to execute the programs ourselves, right, by adding some instructions or by removing some redundant instruction, we'll not be getting the feel of the programming part. So for that purpose, in many programs, right, intentionally I have added the some redundant instructions which are not required, right? You can execute the program, but those instructions can be eliminated and still you can execute the program, right? So my objective is you should be able to find out those redundant instructions in a program and then remove them and then try to execute it once again. Okay, so in today's class we have discussed three programs. One is for arranging the numbers in either ascending order or descending order, then finding the factorial of a given number, and then generating the Fibonacci series. In the next class, we will discuss about the interfacing part, how to interface a switch and LED to 8051 microcontroller. As we all know that microcontroller has got four ports, port 0, port 1, port 2, and port 3. And each port has got 8 I/O ports. So total we have 32 I/O ports. So for interfacing purpose, which port we need to use, right? We'll discuss all those things in the next class. Thank you.